praise the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. All right. Well, let's get started. Let's have a word of praise before I get started, and then I'm going to have Pastor play a song into your hearing. Amen. Father God, in the name of Jesus, Lord, we give you thanks for tonight, Father God. We continue to bless you, Father God. We continue to have the understanding that you will allow us to have, Father God. Now, Father God, that the word come forth, Father God, that you will give tonight, Father God. Let it be under the good soil, Lord, and let it be fruitful, and let it multiply like only you would have it to be, Father God. Let your people hear the word, apply the word, and do the word, Father God. So, Father God, we give you thanks tonight, Father God, for all that you have done for us, Father God, and the continual blessings that you have poured over our life, Father God. So we give you the thanks and we give you the praise. In your name, Jesus. Amen.
Amen. Are you ready for the song now, Deacon?
Yes, sir.
All right.
Every voice say you are everything.
Oh, praise the Lord. Thank God. He's everything. You know, what reminds me of is just that what? It's always been there for us. I'm just thankful. There's no one like him. No one. So as I get prepared for the word that God, and it God lines his word up, you know, and so you can tell yourself that's the way God does it, because he does it decent in order, and the order of his word just compels itself to the next chapter in your life. And so it means that it's getting you through and getting you through and getting you through. So I run through these past messages that God gave, and I don't take it lightly because of what God does for us. When Pastor Harris came last Wednesday, and he was talking about what does Israel matter. Israel matters because it's God's chosen nation. It's his covenant people. And so when you think about that, you have to ask yourself in your life, in your time, that with your covenant with God, you and yourself, are you the chosen vessel that has God called to do the will, do the work, get the understanding of all that God will have you to do? My throat had been bothering me the last couple of days, but God is my strength and he is my rock. And so then Sister Felicia this past Sunday in Sunday school, and she taught, God loves you. Remember that. Now, in all that, you get an understanding too. When God loves you that much to give you a message like these, then you have to have an understanding that this is about the business of God. And in this word, it's how we make it through and how we get through and to our next chapter in our life. And so we got to be on point with getting the message. And so when he says, talk, God loves you, remember that. That means don't forget that God loved you this much to wake you up this morning. He loved you this much to keep seeing about you and the ones that you love. And then the next message, the second hour, came that Sunday, and Pastor Hackett taught God's love. Now, I find that it's lining up, and it keeps reminding you, keeps reminding you, keeps reminding you. And so the thing about that, when God reminds you of something like that, that means that God is getting once your attention to understand that is he that loves thee, and see, not the world that confess that they love you until they get tired and sick of you. So God gave me a message, and it's like, wow, look, God's mind blowing. And so tonight, the word that God gave me to encourage his people, the title would be, don't give up. You see, we cannot give up because we serve a mighty good God. We serve a God that's the God of all gods. And so there is no one like him. Amen. And so I'm just thankful that God is still on the throne. And all that matters is that he is on the throne. Oh, praise God. So we're going to dig into Psalms 23. Psalms happens to be God's word is also important to me. But Psalms is one of my favorite books in the Bible. Psalms 23. The book of Psalms is known to be the book of praise because almost every psalm contains some note of the praise to God. Now think about it. The praise to God. Psalms. Loving God, understanding how God loves you and treats you and digging in. So we get to know that Psalms, that the book of praise, you say you want to get a breakthrough, you praise God. If you want something to happen, you praise God. You see, the thing about it is praising God, not letting your praise die and let it get away. But we continue to praise God, for he is worthy of all the praise. So we say he's worthy of all the praise in all our doing and all our going through. We get an understanding that we have to praise God in order to get through, to make it through. And that's how we can make it through and get through. We are in a place where we are to know that how we are loved on and how special we are to God. This is it. We are loved and special to God. Now, Psalms 23 reads this. The Lord is my shepherd and I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still water. He restored my soul. He leadeth me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, do I walk through the valley of the shadow of death. I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, thy comfort me. Oh, praise God. Thou preparest the table before me in the presence of my enemy. Thou anoint my head with oil. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. So you got to take that scripture and that verse of what it is and what it's for. You know, see, God doesn't take all day to do anything. God moves just like he's going to move. We just have to stay in that place where God wants us to be. Waiting on God, but in that waiting on God, remember to praise God throughout all that it comes this way, that comes your way. So Psalms verse 1 says, the Lord is my shepherd and I shall not want. You got to remember. Now, in the scripture, in this word, you got to take it personally. Your relationship with God, you got to take it personally. So the Lord says, he's my shepherd and I shall not want. Meaning that there's things in life that are necessary and there's things in life that aren't necessary. So God knows my desires of your heart, my heart. And he will give us some things that the desires of our heart. But we got to remember, it's all important to ourselves to understand that it is not that what God gives us that is our timing, but it's about his timing in his giving unto us. So we got to understand that the Lord is the shepherd. I shall not want. So meaning I'm not wanting, I'm always having. God does not leave me empty. I'm always filled with what he wants me to have. See, we lack nothing, because if we lack, we shall ask. So this is it. This is how you get through. You continue to praise God, you continue to understand the book of praise. You continue to thank God, for he is God Almighty. There is no other besides him. We have to get to the point where we take the word personally and walk in the word. Sister Cherie said to use walk on the word, put it in her shoe. How many of you guys walking on the word and put it in your shoe? You see, When you're walking on the word, believing the word, because you know the word is true indeed. There's nothing false about God's word. It's true. God's not a man that he shall lie, but the Spirit of God. Now, verse 2 says, he maketh me to lie down in green pasture. He leadeth me beside the still water. But I was reminding you that in that mayhem and that craziness, I'm going to lay you down and I'm going to give you some rest. And I'm going to make all this other stuff be still on the behalf, okay, because I love you that much. Now, it's great to know that God loves you that much, that he's going to give you a resting place where you can rest and the mayhem stop and gives the peace that passes all understanding, meaning that he's giving you the rest that you needed in this time and in this lifetime. Sometimes we get to the place where we're dealing with a whole bunch of stuff. The verse says, he making me to lie down, see, so I can rest. It leadeth me beside what? The still water. So he's leading me into a place where I can rest and it is still get my peace and understanding till God is in control. And there is nothing that can control the control of God. Now we stepped into this fully. We're aware of God's doing. God's doing is like no other doing. His business is his business of doing like no other because he's God. And no man can do what God does. Then verse 3 says, he restored my soul. He leadeth me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. God is leading me. He's restoring me. He's strengthening thee. He's strengthening you. You think about it. Where you're weak at, God has strengthened you to be strengthened to be able to go through what you have to go through. For his name's sake. Does not say my name's sake. Does not say this world's name's sake. But it says his name's sake. Meaning God Almighty, himself, only God. That's when you would tell yourself, only God can do this. And only God can get me to the place where I have to be in the next chapter of my life, my journey. We've been in this fight for a while now, this body of Christ, and telling ourselves that we are able to make it. That's why we can't give up. Don't give up. Now, verse 4 says, yea, do I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Meaning God has comforted me. Jesus has comforted me. The Holy Spirit has comforted me. Yet I'm in the valley of the shadow of death. Meaning that in that madness, in that craziness, God is there with me. He's there with you. God wants you to know that this is the time to realize that it is him that is with you and no one else. No one else can treat you and do you like God. No one could treat Job like God treated Job. No one could treat David like God treated David. So you got to understand that in this Bible, no one could treat them like God could treat them. You see, to go against the word of God is a no-go, meaning that the will of God is all that we need to know. Going against God's will as we defeat the purpose in life that which God gave us. So meaning that we are in this life that God gave us, but we get to understand that we must be able to understand, yet I may be endure some things and go through some things, but God has blessed me indeed to get through these things. Come on, somebody. You know what I'm talking about. God has blessed you indeed to get through this. When God drops a word on you, that means it's time to get busy. God wants you to understand the healing power and the power that lies within you to do the will of His. There is no other way but the will of God. The world's way will get you nowhere. It's here to confuse us, mess us up, jack us up, and then some. And verse 5 says, thou prepares a table before me in the presence of my enemies. Thou anoint my head with oil, my cup running over. He prepared this place for you. Now, in all that happens, in all that you go through, or with the enemy and the confusion that he has caused you, and time after time after time, that God said he anoint thee. With the oil. Cup run it over. See, his cup run it over means that you're not empty at any time because God keeps your cup filled. And so when you keep God in your life, that means you keep yourself filled and not lacking. And so where you lack, you have to ask God to fill your cup. Give me some more. We all should be wanting more of God. Doing the will of God, understanding that God is the only one who can do us in such a way that we know that we're loved truly. Now, the verse 6 says, surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Meaning that the goodness of the Lord will always be with me because of who he is, because he's the goodness. Mercy shall follow me all the days of my life. And so yet when I'm not even doing what I'm supposed to do that I know to do, God's mercy is still upon me, still upon you. And so dwelling in this house, meaning dwelling in the house, your place where your space, where you is just you and God. You and God. That secret place, you and God. That dwelling place, you and God. So you got to taking this word, taking this life personally with you and God. I'm on my way, God, because you gave me a way. I'm listening because there's something that you want to say and give me. The move of God is like no other move because there is no other God. That is why there is no other move like God. So I'm fighting and I'm remembering to fight a good fight. And so I'm fighting a good fight even in the midst of the storm that I'm in because God is with me. And so as God is with me, he reminded me that Psalms 23, he's with me and he's my Lord and he's my shepherd. And he's always with me. And what do I need when I have the shepherd indeed in front of me, with me? You got to tell yourself God is with you at all times, no matter what. And so when I go through this and go through that, God is still with me because of who he is and who I am to him. You remember, I'm in this fight because God put me in the fight. God put you in the fight because he knew you could fight. We can't give up because God hasn't gave up on us. So when it comes to this life we live, we got to continue to walk by faith.
Yet we may not see it happening yet, but we must believe it deep down in our spirit that yet it will come to pass, but keep moving in the process until it comes to pass. Some of us get the lackadaisical. Sometimes we get stuck. And so we don't move because we don't see. And so I want to encourage you, you don't have to see it in order for it to be done. You just have to believe the word of God that will come and be done. You know, you have to speak life to yourself. Speak healing over your life. God has put this word for us to be able to get through and make it through. And so we got to have an understanding when we come together in unity, the blessing has already been commanded by God. Oh, come on, somebody. God is a good God, and only God can do it. You say, I need God right now. Well, see, God is a right now God. So if you need him right now, he's going to move the way he's going to move. You got to stay busy in that process of whenever it is that that move takes place. You got to understand, are you truly blessed? You truly anointed. Where you can lay hands on yourself and be healed. Speak a word to yourself. Remind you the relationship that you have with God. God still hears you and he sees you. That's the reason we got to keep going. We got to keep going. We got to keep going. We cannot stop. We have to keep going. The Lord is my shepherd and I shall not want, meaning nothing at all shall I want for, because God, he will supply the need that is needed. Speak it out your mouth. God is who he says he is, and there is nothing else to say about it. When God anoints you and appoints you, you must be about the business of God and do what God said to do and say what he said to say. God is your rock. He's your strength. And it's only him that can get you through. We got to keep going. We got to keep going. We got to keep going. Yet I'm saying, I feel a little weary, but I must keep going because of my strength. It's the Lord strengthening me. I'm in it to win it. God is always winning. He never loses. His people always win no matter what. Tonight, you got to tell yourself, I can't give up in this life that I live because God has not gave up on me. I have to keep going. The message that has been coming forward has been coming forth in such a way to encourage my people to do the will. That's what God is telling you. But are you listening to him telling you how he feels about you? Our steps are ordered by God. We got to remember, God is the order, and our steps have been ordered by him. Somebody needs to say, I'm hungry. I'm hungry. See, when you say I'm hungry, that means I'm hungry for you, Lord. More of you, God. You see the blessings of the Lord. The blessings of the Lord to rich and add no sorrow, meaning that whenever it is that God blesses me, there is no mess behind it, because God don't bless no mess. He is the best. So how do you see yourself? Do you see yourself as the best? Because when God saved you, you were a mess. I was a mess. But I remind you, stay in the fight. Continue to fight the good fight. Don't give up. That is the easy part in this life that we live, is to give up. Stand in the fight is what we must do. Never worried about tomorrow, but understanding the day that God gave us. Praising God fully. All I want to do is give God the praise, because the praise belongs to God. And so Psalms is the praising book. And so give through that word, that praise, give God some praise, give God some praise. We need to give God some praise. Yet, yeah, we're going to go through, but we still got to give God praise, because we still here and we're going to make it through. Understand, we are here because God chose us to be, and he loves us that much. Praise is what I do. Praise is what you do when you're going to get close. Well, we all should be praising continuously, because we should be wanting to always be close to him. I understand my value because the input that God has given me. You see, the only thing about this is that when God puts it in you, what will you do with it? We got a blessed church of people in this ministry. And see, yet some of us have not even tapped into that of the blessing that will overflow and take over. We only have got parts of it here and there, some of us. But when you truly trust God and you understand that the blessings of the Lord just continually come and come and come, and it does not stop, meaning that I need to keep going in this fight that I'm in with my Lord. So I can't give up. I can't give up. You can't give up. Tonight we going to get to the point where we realize we cannot give up. We must stay the course. We must stay on track. We must understand that the Lord is our shepherd, and we shall not want. Because he what? Shall supply all our needs. Has he not supplied our needs today, then, forever? We serve a mighty good God. And so since we serve a God that's so mighty and so good, we can't tap out. So assemble yourself among the saints that you be strengthened. Remember, the word is what the word is. How else can you be strengthened unless you assemble yourself with what God told you among the saints? Didn't say among the world, among the saints. So whatever the work we have to do, we're strengthened because of the unity and the commanded blessing that was over our life. And so when we get to the point, we understand that, then we can walk fully aware of God wants us to go at any time. And so not question whether it happens right now or happens later on. Not worried about what a man will say, but understanding what God has said. God is our strength. He's our rock. He's our everything. And the only way to make it through is to keep going in his name. Lord, strengthen this ministry, strengthen this body of Christ like only you can, Jesus. We must keep going. keep going. We cannot stop. The enemy would like us to stop coming together. He would like us to get from being together. So I know the church building is on its way. So when you come together and you speak life into that circumstance or that situation of us coming together and coming together and coming together, because in unity God commanded a blessing over this church and this body of Christ, then we get the understanding that we must be in unity of the prayer of coming together. Somebody say, I'm hungry. So you got to be hungry. Lord, feed me more. Lord, give me more. Lord, if I don't understand, give me understanding. It's not easy in this life, but we must understand that we can make it. We are not to give up, but we are to understand that we must strengthen the coming together which God called us to do. Lord, strengthen us, strengthen us, strengthen us. Keep us, keep us, keep us. You see, I'm so happy that Jesus came and seen about me. I'm so happy that he came and he seen about you. You see, it's where you rejoice with those who rejoice and had understanding that I'm rejoicing of the happiness and the blessings thereof, which God has blessed you and me. We got to fight the good fight. So I thank God for allowing me to come forth in this hour. I thank God for all that he has done. I leave you with this. Don't give up, because he loves you. God loves you. You must understand God has always been there and he will strengthen you then and now. So God always will be there. Always with you. God has not left you, because he's everywhere. You just have to be standing and understanding how to call him, how to hear him. And then when you hear him and he gives you the order, how to carry the order out. So greater light, the next time you're feeling weak, the next time you're going through, remind yourself, your God is all that you need. He's the only way I can make it. He's the only way you can make it. He's the only way any of us can get through. He's our Lord. He's our Savior. He's our shepherd. And in that, we shall not want, because he shall supply all our needs. Amen. God bless you tonight. Let me pray. Father God, in the name of Jesus, Father God, I ask that you strengthen this body of Christ. Continue to work us over, God, and do us, God. Continue to give us what we need in the hours that you have given us, Father God. Father God, leaning not to our own understanding, but acknowledging you in all that you do, Father God. Father God, now bless your people. Bless your people with prosperity. Bless your people with healing, Father God. So we give you thanks tonight, Father God, for all that you have done for us in this life. Father God, we continue to give you praise for what will happen and will come, Father God. So we bless you in everything, Father God. So we give you the thanks, we give you the praise. And God, we thank you most of all for you, Father God. Father God, we thank you for the unity and the commanded blessing, Father God. We thank you for us being cheerfully givers, Father God, that you have made us, Father God. So Father God, we bless you. We give you thanks, we give you praise. For all that it does, all that you do, we bless you in your mighty name, in Jesus' name, amen. God bless you, brothers and sisters.
Amen. Thank you, Deacon. Such a powerful, powerful word tonight. But before I do just a brief summary, I want to pray for you. Father God,
amen.
Deacon, thank you for using him tonight to break the bread of life, to feed your sheep.
Lord, thank you
for the wisdom, the knowledge, the depth of understanding that you have given unto him. And I pray that you will continue to pour into him and use him in a mighty way. Build a hedge of protection around him, his entire family, and continue to bless them.
Lord Jesus.
Amen.
Amen.
Yes.
Amen.
Powerful word of encouragement. Don't give up.
Yes, Lord.
Many of us are facing things these days that even to some degree it will cause us to even ponder on our faith, give it up on our walk, because things become so strenuous in life, so stressful, so heartbreaking, that it would cause us to falter in our walk. But as you gave us the 23rd Psalms, and I like how you highlighted each of the verses and what I was able to write down, you said in the first verse, there is no want in God. There is no lack in him. Everything that we have need of comes from his hands.
Yes. Amen.
How valuable is a sparrow compared to you? That little bird, he doesn't want for anything. And if God takes care of him, much more so will he take care of us.
In
the second verse, you said, God is a place of rest and peace. We can rest in him. We can have peace of mind.
Yes.
We can cast worry to the side. God is our strength.
Yeah.
I am weak. He is strong in me. God is my tower, my rock, my unfaltering God. He is all powerful in all circumstances. You said, God, he comforts me in my darkest hour. As I go through the valley of the shadow of death. Right there with me.
He
said, I will never leave you nor forsake you.
Yes.
I will be with you always. Then you said in the fifth verse, how he anoints our heads and he overflows our cups. He gives us more than enough.
Because
see, he has called us sons and daughters.
Most High God.
And if we are his sons and daughters, he's going to take care of us.
Yes, indeed.
He's going to overflow our cups.
And
in the last verse, and I picked this up from Sister Petty on last Friday morning prayer call. That's why we encourage everybody to come. You might get something out of that prayer call. But she said, her life's companions are goodness and mercy. See, goodness and mercy have followed me all my days and are still with me today, helping me to make this walk. Even when I have to go through the valley of the shadow of death, I got goodness and mercy that are walking with me.
Thank you, Jesus.
Side by side. You said we need to walk in faith by sight. Because everything we can't see, but if we trust God, we have to understand that he will bring us through. God is our rock and our strength. You said that we cannot give up because God ain't giving up on us.
Yes.
We got to stay in the fight. We have to understand that even as God gave the word to Hezekiah, when he was faced with insurmountable odds and the army was surrounding him, God came to him and told him, says, look, the battle is not yours.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
It's the Lord's. So don't give up, you said, because God loves you.
Yeah.
Such a powerful word. Hallelujah. Of encouragement.
Amen.
No matter what you might be dealing with, don't give up.
That's right.
God's got you.
Hallelujah.
Put your faith in him. He'll never fail you. So I thank you, Deacon, for sharing.
Amen.
With us tonight. Such a powerful.
Hallelujah.
And encouraging word, especially in this day and age when there's much.
Yes, Lord. What's
going on?
Amen.
So Amen. Much. But I want to open the floor for our pastor. Pastor Hackett, are you on this evening, sir? Pastor Hackett? He might not be, or if he is, he might not be able to speak, but I'll ask Elder Stubblefield if you'd like to say a word or two.
Amen. Praise the Lord. Thank God, Deacon, for that word. Amen. You know, that this is a message of perseverance. And you said, don't give up. Because, you know, what's interesting is that God never fails.
That's right.
God cannot lose.
That's right.
God is all powerful.
Mm-hmm.
So how is it that we sometimes get into situations where we want to throw in the towel?
Huh. Yeah. Yeah.
And as if we don't have a God who's able to do exceeding abundantly above all that mm-hmm. we can ask or think. Mm-hmm. Amen. So I appreciate the message tonight, because it is what we all need to have in terms of a mindset mm-hmm. that, you know, we keep going because God is keeping us going. Praise yes.
the Lord. Yeah.
There's no reason why anybody should feel like they need to quit. You know,
when
I say that, I mean, based on what you're saying, we're talking about quitting the things that God has equipped us to do,
mm-hmm.
the things that we are anointed to do,
yeah,
and or the things that we're supposed to do. Amen. So mm-hmm. I thank God for the encouragement tonight.
Glory to God.
God bless you for Amen. Using you in that manner to give us that word. Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord, Pastor. Thank you so much for giving me some time.
Amen. Thank you, Elder.
Amen.
That's right. We need to be encouraged that if God is for us, who can be against us, right?
That's right.
You know, it don't matter what the odds might be. If you got God on your side, you more than the world.
Yeah. Yeah.
Deacon Colston.
Well, amen, amen, and amen. Thank you for that word, Deacon Stephenson. Don't give up. That, I agree with the Pastor and Elder on what they said. It's encouraging, and it's a word of perseverance. You know, it's almost, you know, I got the sense it's like being on a battlefield or taking this walk that we take, you know. Sometimes we can give up or lose hope and faith if we face something that is, I'm gonna say, seemingly so traumatizing to us.
Mm-hmm.
But, you know, I kept hearing when you was speaking, I kept hearing run back, go back. So it's like, go back to God, return to God, seek God, go back. So it's like, if God is one mm-hmm. behind us, if the Holy Spirit is shadowing us one step, he's not far off. He's closer and guiding and pushing and protecting and energizing and doing everything that he needs to do to keep us going.
Yeah.
So that's the vision of the, that's the gist of the message that I got from you. So it was a great message, a great time.
Amen.
Thank you for the word, and you know, thank you for allowing God to use you in that way.
Amen.
Amen.
Continue to keep doing what you're doing.
Amen. To God be the glory. Amen.
It was such a powerful word.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord.
Amen. Praise the Lord.
Can you hear me okay? I was hearing you, Deacon. I was hearing you. I was feeling you too.
Hallelujah. Like,
you know, if God will never leave us or forsake us, then why would we leave the plan that he's designed for us? Why would we walk away from the direction that he has the full operation and plan already laid out?
Mm-hmm.
You know, as you know, Deacon Colson just said, it was a persevering word, the type of word that gives you the strength to push through, to keep going, like you said. Why stop? You know, sometimes we can want to put the brakes on, the emergency brakes, get out and put some angles behind the tires and in the front. You know, and just do what they say, safety first. But you got to understand, the perseverance will make you conquer.
Yes.
And if I keep pushing with the presence that lives in me, then what, like Elder Stubblefield just said, what won't God allow me to do, us to do, each and every one of us to do and accomplish that is set forth by his word, by the acknowledgement of who we are to him and how we walk in the strength of our salvation.
Yeah.
Well, just like you said, you just got to keep on pushing. When the trials get tough, when the tough don't get going, quitters never win and winners never quit.
That's right.
Is the gist of what you were saying. So if my plan that I have set out to do is to win, then even when it gets tough, even when it doesn't seem like it's all the way going to work out, if I exercise the patience and allow the presence to give me the strength to keep on pushing, and hey, I always say the sky is not the limit.
Glory to God.
The sky is not the limit. Sometimes we can make sure we're sure-footed. We say it's got to land on strong ground. And you know, if we're standing strong and we got a sure foundation, then we shouldn't waver in the things that God has given us. Because I always say, if the giver of thoughts had the thought to give me the thought, then why would I think different other than the thought that he gave me? The thoughts are real. I was just had a conversation right before Bible study. The thoughts are real. It's the dedication and determination that are the hardest parts, right? So you got to stay dedicated. You got to stay determined. So it may seem like it's the heaviest part of whatever you're looking to accomplish, but God's favor is upon us. So, take no thought for things not working out, because God has us and he's with us, like you said during your message. So I'm glad I was able to be on. I thank, Deacon and Elder for coming on and giving their response, and Pastor as well. You know, I appreciate the word tonight. Great job. Excellent. Great presentation. Great delivery.
Amen.
And anointed too. And you pussy. It'd been different if you said, well, you know, I got a little tickle in my throat and my nose is a little stuffed up. you know what I'm saying? Yeah. But you pushed through. brought a perspective that we can thank the Lord for tonight.
So amen.
God bless you tonight. God bless you.
God be the glory. Amen.
Amen. Thank you, Pastor.
Yeah, no problem. Sorry about the delay. I had to get to a place where it would suffice for me to talk, okay?
I love you
all.
No worries.
Have a great night, and God bless. I'll be on as long as I can, hopefully to the end, because I love the prayer and everything that's coming forth. If you can remember me and my family and all the Greater Life family when we get to that point, I'm looking forward to somebody else's response, because these type of words, like you said, will give us a clear perspective of what we can learn from each other when we do these responses and have the time to actually talk about the goodness of the Lord in such a way. So I thank you too. God bless you.
Amen.
And, amen. Keep on pushing, Deacon.
Amen.
Amen.
All right. Amen. God bless. Right. Keep on pushing, everybody. Greater Light.
Come on now.
Yeah.
That's right.
All right.
That's right.
God bless everybody.
God bless.
God bless.
Amen.
God bless. All right. I want to see if there's any of the ladies that would like to share a thought. We don't want to have it just be men only. Just unmute yourself if you'd like to comment. Nobody?
Amen. Thank you for being here tonight. God bless you.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. I just want to say thank you so much, Deacon, for that powerful word. It was definitely encouragement to me. Yes. You know, you said several times that the message, you have to take God's word personal. I take every message, and especially this message, personally. It felt like you were just talking to me personally. Don't give up. Keep going. Keep going. Don't give up, no matter what it looks like. So I just thank God for using you tonight. God bless.
Amen. God bless.
Amen. Thank you, Sister Harris. Amen. I see Sister Georgia has her mic open. Sister Georgia.
Praise the Lord. God bless each and everyone. Greetings to everyone. God bless you, Deacon Stephenson. I was listening, you know, I think about the 23rd Psalm. Every time I hear someone say something, it's a different, it's so, God's word is so mighty, you know, that you hear something different every time. I just wanted to say, especially, I'm not even sure what verse it is. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death. It's not my thought. It was somebody I heard that say, if you don't have light, then you cannot find a shadow. There's always a shadow. If there is light, then you will find a shadow. If it's dark, you can think about it or even test it. If you're walking down the road and it's dark, there's no shadow. As long as there's light, then you will have a shadow. So it's nothing. There's no reason for us to fear because there is light. The valley is always, there's nothing wrong with the valley. There is light in the valley. Yeah. It's just that you have to climb out of the valley to get to the top of the mountain.
Uh-huh.
So, and another thought is, there's no failure in God. We are the ones that have the problems. We are the ones that don't believe or doubt or fear. There's no failure in God. There is light. If there's a light, then there's a shadow. And God is not a God of failure. Praise God. Amen. Praise God. Amen.
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 Amen. Thank you.
Thank you for giving me the privilege. Thank you so much.
Amen.
Wow, that was powerful. If there's no light, there's no shadow, Deacon. That was powerful.
That's it. Yeah.
Come on now. No matter how dark the situation might be, there's always light.
That's right.
Always light. Amen.
Always light. Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah. Amen.
So we're going to, I guess, let me ask Deacon Wolf, do you want to share a word before we transition to prayer? Deacon Wolf? He might not be available. Well, we're going to go ahead and transition our service. I want to thank you again, Deacon, for allowing God to use you in such a powerful way. 23rd Psalms is one of my favorite passages of scripture. And as Sister Georgia said, there's always something new in the scripture. You know, everybody has a different take on it. And God's word is just not relegated to one particular thought. It could be many different things.
Amen.
So I thank God for his word tonight. But I want to, announcements, just to remind everybody, 5 a.m. prayer, Friday morning, led by Sister Felicia, Sister Trish, and Sister Madeline. Set your alarm clocks, get up, join in, so you don't miss out. God is always moving on Friday morning prayer. We'll be on the Zoom this coming Sunday for Sunday service, 8:30 a.m. prayer, 9 o'clock Sunday school, and 10:30 worship service. So jot those times down. Remember our upcoming services. Also, as a reminder, probably in the next week or two, we will make an announcement regarding our church finance meeting that we'll be having on Wednesday night, Bible study night. So stay tuned. We'll get the announcement out, and that way everybody can join in and we can discuss our church business. Amen. But at this time, I want to transition and ask a member of the finance team if they would lead us in our offering tonight.
Praise the Lord, everybody. Amen. God bless you. Amen. This is a day the Lord has made. We shall rejoice and be glad in it. Amen. At this time, we are going to honor the Lord with our substance and with the first fruits of all of our increase.
Yes,
Lord. Praise the Lord. That is the word of the Lord. Amen. Concerning this matter, I'm going to read our scripture. Amen, that we read as we enter into the worship of giving. Amen. It is a form of worship. Praise the Lord. Yes, Lord. We're going to go to the book of Malachi and the third chapter, and we're going to go to the 10th verse. And I know that everyone in this ministry can recite this by heart. Amen. So why don't you just do that with me as I go forth and deliver this. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Bring ye all the tithes into the storehouse, that there may be meat in mine house. And prove me now herewith, saith the Lord of hosts, if I will not open you the windows of heaven and pour you out a blessing, that there shall not be room enough to receive it. And I will rebuke the devourer for your sakes, and he shall not destroy the fruits of your ground, neither shall your vine cast her fruit before the time in the field, saith the Lord of hosts. And all nations shall call you blessed, for ye shall be a delightsome land, saith the Lord of hosts. Amen. Lord, that is God. Maybe Jesus. One day, Lord willing, I'll do a Bible study on the Lord of hosts.
Glory to God. And amen.
Understand the essence of the phrase, the Lord of hosts.
It's
translated to mean the Lord of armies.
Hallelujah. Oh, glory.
Amen.
Glory to God.
And so
amen.
If you understand that God is using that particular title along with the essence and his instructions for giving,
yes,
that would indicate that we would have the power of the Lord's armies with us.
Yeah.
If Amen. We just follow the instructions of the Lord. It says, prove me now herewith, saith the Lord of hosts.
Yes.
I will not open through the windows of heaven. In other words, God's going to cause his host
to
facilitate some processes. His host is going to do a few things that might not be able to be done in the natural. His hosts are going to do what only God can do and
orchestrate
based on the will of God and the blessings that he sends to his people for honoring the word of the Lord. Because if you're going to prove God, he's going to get his hosts.
That's right.
In Jesus' name. You read it for yourself. It's in there. You just got to ask God to give you that type of revelation.
Yes, yes.
Because the Bible tells us this is a living word. It is a rhema word. It's not a dead letter. Amen.
That's right.
Praise the Lord. I'm done with that. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah.
Yes, God.
We're going to go to the book of Luke, the sixth chapter. Hallelujah. Luke 6 and 38. I heard somebody say that they are a Luke 6 and 38 woman, or some brother said,
yes,
Luke 6 and 38 man. Amen. So why don't we just be a Luke 6 and 38 people? Amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Amen. Yeah, I'm sorry. I've been in presentation mode all week. I've had an event every day this week. Got two tomorrow and one on Friday. Praise the Lord. So I stay ready. Amen.
Yes,
come
sir.
On, somebody. We on the battlefield for the Lord. Amen. Come on,
yes,
somebody.
Lord.
The word of the Lord says, give and it shall be given to you.
That's right.
Good measure. That's one. Press down. That's two. And shaking together. That's three. And running over. That's four. Shall men give into your bosom? That's five. Five is God's number of grace. Five things coming to you based on
thanksgiving.
Hallelujah. And then God said, hold up. We ain't done. He said, the same measure that you meet with all is be measured to you again. Hallelujah. God said, you know what? I'm going to show you how to multiply stuff. Whatever measure that you're doing, he said, I'm going to do it. He said, with that same measure,
that's
right. It's being that he's got a supernatural measure.
Ooh, glory to God. Glory to God.
I don't know about you, but I'm believing God for big stuff.
That's right.
In 2024.
Come on. Amen.
You better have some faith for four figures, for five figures, for six, for seven figures. You say, well, Elder, it's not about the money. No, it ain't about the money. It's about the assignment. And you need money to finish the assignment.
That's right.
You need money. You need money just to go to church because you need gas in your car. So don't tell me it's not about the money, because it really isn't. But we do need the money. Like Pastor Harris always say, he talks about
you,
we got to support the church through our tithe. Now, the Lord mandates that tithe.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. He lets you figure out the offering part.
Thank you, Lord.
He give you the tithe amount. Praise the Lord. Isn't God awesome? Hallelujah.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. I'm done. I'm not trying to jump in here. Pastor, I apologize. Pastor Hackett.
No apology needed.
Hallelujah. God, Harris, come on, somebody.
I'm just in pain
right now.
Come
I'm in vain. Because you know what? Because God said we in a vein right now. Praise
the Lord.
We're just going to just go forth. Why?
That's right.
Because God has given us the ability to go forth in Jesus' name.
In
Amen.
Jesus name.
So we understand that we have no sad stories to tell. I want
everybody to
understand this, that God is a God of love and happiness. Praise the Lord. The Bible says in the presence of the Lord is the fullness of joy. So that's the happiness, joy. So it's a pleasure to serve God. Amen. So we do what we do, hallelujah, because he loved us first.
That's what he said.
We love him because he first loved us. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Y'all better start pronouncing the word over yourselves, declaring God. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
Because this is what should be coming out from our mouths.
Uh-huh.
Hallelujah.
Uh-huh. That's right.
Amen. Deacon done told us that God ain't trying to have us quit. We ain't trying to quit. Ain't nobody trying to quit. Praise the Lord. We're not quitting up in hand. Praise the Lord. So let's go forth.
This is
the word. Amen.
Glory to God. Amen.
God do what only God can do.
That's right.
Just multiply according to his word.
That's right.
And then I'll end with this. And we still were talking about the offering. He said, whatsoever man purpose in his heart, so let him give.
Thank you.
Amen. Jesus. For God loveth a cheerful giver.
Yeah.
He does.
So you got to get happy. You know what? God don't want you giving your tithe and offering with a frown on your face. Right? He don't want you logging into Zelle or Zoom like, man, I got to get this tithe.
Come on, man. Come on.
No, you got to keep it joyful.
That's right.
Praise the Lord.
That's right.
Amen. We're just making this practical, right? We're making it practical because we want God to put his super in our natural.
Oh, my goodness.
Come on now.
In the name of Jesus. Amen. God bless you all. Amen. Have a wonderful evening. Father God, in the name of Jesus, we thank you. Hallelujah. For those that are going to Zelle, we thank you for those that are going to Church Track. We thank you for those that are mailed their offerings and tithes in. Father God, you are the God of provision. You are Jehovah.
Yes.
The Lord, our provider. Father God, you don't run out. Father God, your supply is never ending.
Glory.
Hallelujah. You are abundant. Hallelujah. Father, we thank you. Hallelujah. For serving you, Father God, for life. And as you said, life more abundantly. We thank you.
More,
we praise you, Lord Jesus. We're asking you to bless the needs of the church. We're asking you to bless the needs of the mothers. Hallelujah. Bless the needs of the sisters. Bless the needs of
glory to God.
Father God, bless the needs of the men. Father God, every ministry of this church. Bless the needs of our pastors. Bless the needs of their families. Father God, in the name of Jesus, we know, hallelujah, that you shall supply all of our need according to your riches and glory by Christ Jesus, because that's what your word says.
Yes.
So we're putting the word on it tonight, Lord.
Yes.
In Jesus' name, we thank you and we praise you.
Yes, Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Amen. Thank you, Elder.
Thank you, Jesus.
Amen.
Come on.
Hallelujah.
God be praised. Yes, indeed.
Oh, Lord.
This time we're going to move along and we're going to have prayer. Sister
Joma. My God. Thank you, Jesus.